إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise is due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguided, no one will guide him. I bear witness and I believe there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. We are in the holy month, the month of Dhul Hijjah, and tomorrow by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Yawm Arafah, the best day of all the year. The day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept and give forgiveness for many people. The day where the people performing Hajj, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the forgiveness and rahmah and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have a gathering in Hajj. In that day, Yawm Arafah, in the sacred place, in the holy place, and all of them, they have a gathering. They have one aim, to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking Him and supplicating to Him that Allah give them al-Jannah and save them from the hellfire. And as we are in the series of the attribute and description of the people of al-Jannah, the people of paradise, today, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are in the sifah, in the attribute number 15. Number 15, the character of at-tawbah, the attribute of at-tawbah, repentance, repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking His own forgiveness. So the quality and the character of the people of Al-Jannah, when they were in dunya, they always with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeking forgiveness and asking Him to forgive them. That's their character and that's their quality. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them and honor them and give them Al-Jannah, the final destination, Al-Jannah, the final beautiful place, paradise, the one Allah created and prepared for the true believer. Their character, they used to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's how we can realize and analyze the people performing Hajj. They standing in Arafat, and most of their dua, ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh our Lord, oh our Lord, our Creator, we wrong ourselves, we wrong ourselves, and we did commit wrong and mistake and shortcoming, and we sin, we fall in the sin. So oh our Lord, we return back to You, and we're seeking the forgiveness from You. So forgive us, and Allah surely will forgive them. Let's start with this small clip talking about the repentance and the tawbah, to understand the importance of tawbah, the importance of repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to Allah, come back to Him, and understand the definition of a tawbah. Bismillah.
قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة
Sheikh, he said, when you going to repent? When? Asking when, the time, when you going to repent? The All King, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner, Al-Malik, he give you so much a chance. And he give you so much time to return back to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Malik, he helped you a lot. He give you a chance a lot. He forgive you a lot. And he provide what you need. Even you still falling in the sin. When you're going to repent, ask yourself that question. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if punish or want to take the wrongdoers, إِنَّ أَخْذَهُ أَلِيمٌ شَدِيدٌ, Allah will take them painfully and strongly. أليم, painfully. شديد, strongly. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the wrongdoers. After you fall in the major sin, such as stealing, killing, cheating, lying, doing and committing all this kind of sin, you steal, you fornicate, you did all the wrong things, you watch bad things, you fall in all that haram, can I be a good person? Can I return back to Allah? Can I repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The answer is yes. Yes, you still can have, you still have the chance to return back to Allah and be a good person, pious person and righteous person. Possible that I can return? Are you sure, O Shaykh? Yes. Yes, I'm sure you can return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, I'm sure you can be a good person in whatever you did before. If you will and if you have the will to return back to Allah, Allah will accept you and forgive you. Yes, you can. But what is the condition? The first condition is an-nadam. 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 What is mean by an-nadam? It mean regret. And feel sad about what you did. Regret and feel sad about what did you did. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, this is the main and the most important pillars from the pillar of Tawbah, from the pillars of repentance. It's a main column for the Tawbah, for the repentant and returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the condition number two? To stop and leave and avoid the sin, the one you are in. You cannot be returned back to Allah or repent to Allah and you are in the same sin and say, oh Allah forgive me, and you are doing the same sin. Regret and stop. Regret and stop and avoid and be aware and run away from the sin, the one you are committing. Third, do a lot of from the good deeds, from hasanat, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna al-hasanat yudhibna al-sayyat." Indeed, the good deeds will wipe the bad deeds. So, do as much you can from the good deeds. And if that sin, it's attached or linked to the right of a human being, you have to return the right. Such as, if you steal something and you want to return back to Allah, you regret and you stop stealing, but in the same time you have to return the amount, the one you steal it, to the person. Allahu Akbar. He said, if I want to return back to Allah, Allah will accept me? Yes. What is the evidence from the verses and from the Quran? قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned list of the sum of the sin, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply the punishment for the person, the one they fall in. But the last ayah Allah mentioned, إلا من تاب, except who repent to Allah, وآمن, and he believe in Allah, وعمل عملا صالحا, and he do righteous deed, فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات, those Allah will replace their bad deeds to the good deeds. وكان الله غفورا رحيما, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all forgiving and all merciful. Another evidence from hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أذنب عبدي, in the hadith of Al-Qudsi, which is the معناه refer to Allah, the meaning of that hadith refer to Allah, that a person, he fall in sin and he say, oh my Lord, I fall in the sin, forgive me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the angels, will call and we say, my servant calling me, he fell in the sin and he calling me and seeking forgiveness, so I forgive him. Then that same servant, he fell again in the sin. Then he said, oh my Lord, forgive me. Then Allah will say, my servant knew he has a Lord, he has a creator, he has a Lord. He forgive the sin and he will take because of the sin. I forgive my servant. Then after the same servant, he will say, he fall in the sin. He say, oh my Lord, I fall in the sin. Then Allah will say, my servant knew he has a Lord, forgive the sin and take because of the sin. I forgive my servant and let my servant do whatever he willing to do. This hadith, it's we can take a lesson that so much hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we shouldn't take to be doing the sin or thinking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is it's okay, I can do the sin, it's alright. No, this hadith is teaching us to have a hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, from the meaning of the tawbah, al-iqla'u 'an al-dhanb wal-nadam wa 'adam al-ruju'. He said, from the meaning of the tawbah, you regret, then you stop doing the sin, then you have niyyah, we have attention, you have a will that you will not return back to that same sin. So not say, okay, oh, you regret, I stop now, but tomorrow I will do it again. No, you have to have the niyyah, and have the feeling, and have the will that you don't never ever willing to do it again. This is from the meaning of the tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's find out what is the attribute of the repentance. From the attribute of the repentance, first, his heart broken because he fell in the sin. From the attribute of the repentance, his tears very heavy. From the attribute of the repentance, his feeling is live. He's emotional. He has feeling. He is blaming himself about what he did. The repentance, he has a truthful, true feeling, live feeling. At-Taib, the repentant, he's out of show off and proudness. He is out from the attribute of al-ujub. He like himself. He think he's so good. The repentance, his heart, as we said in the beginning, broken, humble, heavy tears, live feeling. This is the attribute of the repentance, the true repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وأبوء بذنبي
Sheikh, he mentioned the leader of the dua of the seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidul Dua, the master of all dua when you are going to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, say with me in order to remind you and in order to memorize that dua. Allahumma anta rabbi. You can say it also. Allahumma anta rabbi. Oh Allah, you are my Lord. La ilaha illa ant. There is no worthy to be worshipped except you. You are my creator. You are my sustainer. You are my master. You are my ruler. You are almighty. La ilaha illa ant. I have a full tawheed, full in the belief in oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa ant. Khalaqtani. You created me. Wa ana abduk. And I am your servant. I am your servant and you are my creator and you are my sustainer and you are my master. Khalaqtani. Wa ana abduk. Wa ana ala ahdika wa wa'adika mastata'at. And I am in your promise, the one I promised you. And I am in the promise, I am in the will to fulfill the promise, the one I promised you. A'udhu bika min sharri ma sana'at. I seek refuge by you, O my creator, from what I did. I seek refuge from what I did by you, O my creator. Oh my Lord. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي. أبوء mean I declare and I say. أبوء لك, I declare and I believe and I will say about all the bounty, the one I have been, is from you. Subhanallah. Full of surrender to Allah. You declare, you believe that all the things I have is from you, O my Creator. And I declare about the sin, the one I fall in. I declare and I will say that I am really guilty. وَأَبُوءُ لَكَ بِنِعْمَتِكَ عَلَيْهِ فَاغْفِرْ لِي. So forgive me. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتِ. Indeed, nobody can forgive except you. You are the all forgiving. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, this dua. When Nabi Sallam, he said, whomever mentioned that dua or he say it in the morning, مُوَقِنًا بِهِ, and he has a yaqeen, he has a belief in whatever he say. فَمَاتَ مِنْ يَوْمِهِ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And if he died from this day, the day when he said it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the Jannah guarantee for him. And if he say that dua in the night, and if he died from the same night, when he mentioned that dua, with the niyyah, with attention, with yaqeen, with belief, if he died, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make Jannah guarantee for him. And the ulama, they say, huwa sayyidu du'a. It's a leader of all du'a. Sayyidu istighfar, sorry, the leader of all forgiving, seeking forgiveness. Why? Because inside this du'a, full of humbleness. Inside this dua, full of tawheed and iman and faith. Inside this dua, full of declaring the bounty of Allah and the sin, the one you are in. It's all type of tawheed inside that dua. Tawheed al-ibadah, tawheed al-rububiyyah, the lordship and the worship and the sifat, the attribute of Ar-Rahman, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why that dua is very, very amazing dua to say when you are full in mistake or shortcoming. Why you don't say that tubtu ila Allah, I repent to Allah? Why you don't say that, oh Allah, I repent to you, tubtu ilayk, tubtu ilayk, tubtu ilayk, I repent to you, I return back to you, oh Allah. When you're going to repent, when you die, too late. You have the power and ability to repent, yes, so do so. I'm sure you have the ability to repent and you have the will to repent. Don't delay until your heart become hard, then you will don't have the chance to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't know, you are waiting, you are sitting, you don't know that moment and that time when you decide to repent, the same time when the mercy of Allah revealing down or revealed down, then when you seek the forgiveness in that moment, you might achieve the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't delay. I ask you by the name of Allah, repent. I ask you by the name of Allah, astahlifuka billah, to repent to Allah. And don't delay. Allahu Akbar. What an amazing hadith that Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu, he came to the Prophet of Allah Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, my heart is broken. He said, why? He said, from a person he's keeping crying deeply, deeply and hardly, crying, young man next to my door. He said, go and call him. So the person, he came in, and he came to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he was crying. He said, oh man, oh young man, what happened? Why you are so much crying like this? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I did so much sin and I'm scared and worried from my Lord, he will be angry from me. Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, did you fall in shirk? He said, no, I never did that. He said, Prophet of Allah, ask him, did you kill someone? He said, no, Ya Rasulullah, I did not do so. He said, Allah will forgive you sin, even your sin fulfill the seven heaven and the seven earth, if you repent to Him. What an amazing, touching story. What an amazing showing the mercy, how big the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. My mercy widening, very wide, can everything can fit in it. Allahu Akbar, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. Inshallah, after we watch the clip, I hope that all the meaning of the tawbah it's in your mind, but only you need to start forward step to do the implementation. And I would like to repeat the dua for you to write it or to memorize it. What is the dua? The leader of all forgiving. It's there in all the books of remembering of Allah, it's there. Especially if you can buy the Hisnul Muslim, the castle of the Muslim. It's there in remembering Allah of morning and night time. It's there that the dua is written. Allahumma anta rabbi. Allahumma anta rabbi. Oh Allah, you are my Lord. La ilaha illa ant. La ilaha illa ant. The word of Tawheed. Khalaqtani. Khalaqtani. You created me. وَأَنَا عَبْدُكَ وَأَنَا عَبْدُكَ. I am your servant. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينْ. خَلَقْتَنِي وَأَنَا عَبْدُكَ وَأَنَا عَلَىٰ عَهْدِكَ وَوَعْدِكَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتْ. I am in the promise, the one I am in the pledge, the one I give to you, O my Lord. I am in the promise, the one I promise you, O my Lord. I am in the oath, the one I give and declare, O my Lord. As much I can, ما استطعت. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت. I seek refuge by you, O my Lord, from what I did. أبوء لك بنعمتك علي. I declare and I will say that all the bounty is coming from you. And I declare and I will say I am guilty. I am the one, I am the sinner, I am the one full in the sin. I am the one with the shortcoming. Huh? أبوء لك بذنبي فاغفر لي. So forgive me, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْ. No one will forgive the sin except you, O my Lord. You are the all forgiving and you all merciful. A question here. Why the people of Jannah? During the dunya time, when they fall in the sin or shortcoming, straight away, they run and return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they seek forgiveness and they repent to Allah. Why? Why that character? Why this attribute is live in their life? Why this character attribute live in their life? The answer, first point, you can write it down. Because Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory be to Him, He's the one ordered them to repent to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to repent to Him. قال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا. O who believe, repent to your Lord truly repentance. Truly repentance. يا الله توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحة. وقال تعالى وتوبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون. Repent, all who believe, all believer, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of you. لعلكم تفلحون, you might success and reach the successful. So repentance is the way of success. Surah An-Nur, ayah 31. So both of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving a command and order. Tubu, it's an order verb. So from there, we have to take the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to implement. Another evidence from the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, he said, Ya ayyuhal nas, tubu ila Allahi wastaghfiruhu fa inni atubu fil yawmi mi'ata marrah. O people, Rasulullah said, O people, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness from Him, because indeed I repent to Allah daily 100 times. Rasulullah sallam, Prophet of Allah, I repent to Allah daily 100 times. Allahu Akbar, Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he seek forgiveness from Allah 100 times. How about us? We are the full of sin. We are the sinner. We are the mistaken. So if Nabi Sallam doing 100 times repentance and seeking forgiveness, so for us we should do more, or at least like Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, at least minimum. Some people they repent only annually, is it? Or maybe not annually, once in their lifetime when they go to Hajj or Umrah. Subhanallah, where 40 years you forget to repent, and only in the during the Hajj time. La hawla la quwwata illa billah. Some people they understanding, they have wrong understanding for tawbah. They think the tawbah only for criminal, only for killer, only the one he steal the money. For us, we doing salah, we doing Hajj, we doing Umrah, we doing good, so we shouldn't repent. Wrong understanding. Allah says, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Whom? Repent to Allah all. To whom? To the sinner? Or to criminals? Or disbeliever? No. Allah mentioned, أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. All who believe. The believer. So the tawbah should be for the true believer, they have to have tawbah. That's the attribute of the people of Jannah. Point number two. أهل الجنة وهم في الدنيا في دار العمل إذا اقترفوا ذنبا بادروا بالتوبة إلى الله لأنهم قد علموا وأيقنوا أن الله عز وجل وحده هو الذي يغفر الذنب. Point number two, because that this true believer, they have the attribute of the people of Jannah during the dunya, you know what they do? They understand, and they understood very well 100% that only the one have the power and they have ability to forgive whom? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can forgive your sin except Allah. No one can have the power or ability to forgive except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty. So what are you waiting for? Some people they think, I did so much wrong, I have to go to Wali, yeah? Mawlana. Astaghfirullah wa tawbah. Mawlana, forgive me. Ya Mawlana. And some people try to intercession shafa'ah from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now, not asking Allah, Ya Allah, let Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give us shafa'ah on Yawm al-Qiyamah. No, they will not say that. You know what they say? Ya Rasulullah, ishfa' lana. Ya Rasulullah, forgive us. Ya Rasulullah, calling Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not calling Allah. And they have wrong understanding. And wallahi, I was listening to some Islamic song. Subhan today Fajr, after Fajr I'm having my fatur, my breakfast. Astaghfirullah, full of shirk. Full of shirk. Full of seeking the forgiveness and help and intercession, not with Allah, with the Prophet of Allah. The clearly word. Wallahi, if I'm listening to Wal'adhu Billah, the haram song better than what I listen. and they call it Islamic song. They put all the musics in it, and they're using all the shirk word in it, and they call Islamic song, and we are happy. We put it in our house, and we think, we are good Muslim. And if another house, they put it, put wal'adhu billah, famous singer who singing haram song, those bad people. But about you, you listening to the worst. We nowadays people not understanding Islam properly. He said, توسلنا برسول الله وبكل عالم عالم وبكل عارف بالله. We intercession and we seek the forgive by Rasulullah and in every a good person. Not only Rasulullah, also in every human being. La ilaha illallah, where is the direct dua to Allah? Subhanallah, here it's wrong understanding, but the people of Jannah, no. They understood that the forgiveness seeking by Allah. And straight away they come return back to Allah. Be careful. Be careful to fall in some of the evil net from the criminal people. They try to make the shirk beautiful and make the haram beautiful. And they want to make Islam according their own desire, not according what Allah and Rasulullah and the Quran told us. May Allah save us from all this fitna. Another thing, Allah says, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَأْخُذُ الصَّدَقَاتِ. Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 104. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا. Allah talking to the hypocrites, the one they did not go to the battle of Tabuk with the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا. They doesn't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah accept the repentance, accept the tawbah, accept seeking forgiveness. It's only Allah. قال تعالى وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, the one accept the repentance. يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ. Allah did not say Muhammad, he's the one accept the repentance. Allah did not say Mawlana or the Shaykh or the pious person or the or Jibreel or Malaika or no. Allah direct want us to be direct to Him. Subhanallah, look at the Christian. When they fall in the sin, Allahu Akbar, they have to go to the special chair they call Kursi al-I'tiraf, where you declare all your sin in that over that chair, and you as much you pay to the pay money for the priest, your sin will be more forgiven. نسأل الله العفو والعافية. This is driving away from the oneness of Allah and tawheed to the wal'iyadhu billah shirk. But you are allowed, so you have to understand, you are allowed to come to the shaykh or ustad or alim or pious person, said, ya shaykh, ya alim, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me, or ask Allah to give me guidance, no problem. Because you're asking a help from person, he's alive. He can do dua to Allah to you. But don't go to the one already died. Okay, already died. Some people, subhanAllah, in some of the country, I see it by my eyes, when they have a normal situation, they run to Allah. When they have a extremely situation, they run to the creation of Allah. So, astaghfirullah to believe. One woman, he said, ya Mawlana, help, help. My daughter, she is giving birth. She is struggling. Help, help, Mawlana. La ilaha illallah. Mawlana, he is already in the next life. How he can help your daughter? Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Point number three. Ahlu jannati wa hum fi dunya tabu ila Allah li'annahum qad alimu wa ayqanu anna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. The people in Jannah, they understood during the dunya time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, only Allah forgive the sin, and also Allah so much merciful can forgive all the sin. And Allah have the power to replace your sin to the good deeds. Do you know the hadith, the one that newly Muslim, when he is saying shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, and he entered Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive his sin. Not only that, oh, so much merciful from Allah. Allah will replace all his bad deeds to good deeds. MashaAllah, now he has a heavy scale from the good deeds. That all, when your heart direct to Allah, Ya Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open all the mercy door. All the gate of mercy will open for you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive the sin. يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He forgive all your sin, whatever you did in your life. That is very easy on the, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Allah's hands, who can forgive all of that? Even if you commit shirk, if you truly repent to Allah, Allah will forgive. Even if you fall in zina, fornication, you repent to Allah, Allah will accept. Even if you do whatever the sin is, you repent to Allah, Allah will forgive. Please write this ayah, and I wish all of you, subhanahu, memorize it from Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 53, from Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 53. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين. قال تعالى قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. سبحان الله. قل يا عبادي. Oh Muhammad, say to my servants, say to my servants who has asrafu ala anfusihim, whom they fool, and they fool in many sin, or so much sin, they exceed the limit in shortcoming, they exceed the limit in the major sin and minor sin. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Don't lose hope from the mercy of Allah. Don't lose hope from the mercy of Allah. Indeed, Allah forgive all the sin. He is all forgiving and all merciful. Ya Allah, what a beautiful ayah. It has billions, trillions, millions, I don't know what we can say, from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much hope in this ayah. So Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the people who follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallam, if somebody come to you, whatever the sin he did, open your hand to him. Open your hand to her. Hug her and tell her, my sister. Hug him, tell my brother. Allah so much merciful, repent to him and return back to him. Allah will forgive you sin, whatever you did. Put some hope in the heart of the Muslims, in the heart of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is amazing ayah which contains so much hope. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sin. Point number 4. The people of Jannah, when they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they understand why they should repent. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feel happy. Allah will be happy from the person who repent, or he returned back to him. Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sustainer, will be happy from the person who repent back to him? Yes. There is a hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah lillahu ashaddu farahan. Allah more happy. More happy than the person. He give an example. Let me explain to you the example for you to understand. A man, Bedouin, he was traveling in the desert, in Sahara. Suddenly, he stopped to have a rest. And he has his own food and his drink and water and all the one he need. He put it in the over the donkey or camel. And he went and he lay down to sleep. When he wake up, the donkey or the animal or the camel run away. Allahu Akbar. And all his money, all his water, all his food, all his things, clothes, everything with the animal. And he remained empty hand, out of food, out of any source to be alive. The source of life, end. Waiting, keep waiting, keep waiting, 1 hours and hours and hours and hours. Then he lost hope. Wherever he go, nothing. Then what happened to that person? He lie down and he's waiting to die. Can you imagine? You are in the moment, you are waiting to die, you are in the moment to die. Lost all the hope. And that person, he closed his eyes, and suddenly he opened his eyes. What he see? He saw his own animal in front of him. Can you imagine what he will do, this person? He will jump out of happiness. And he will say, Allahumma inni inni ana abdu, Allahumma inni ana rabbuka wa anta abdi. And he make mistake when he making dua. He flipped the word out of happiness. Subhanallah. And here, that how much that person will happy, that the source of life come back to him. Allah more happy or more happier when the person return back to him. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. What an amazing understanding at Tawheed, and understanding the true meaning of Tawbah. Understanding and knowing Allah more, that Allah will feel happy, Allah will be happier than that person who lost all the source of life when you return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, in 1 minute now, talk to yourself. If Allah will be so much happy if I repent to him, oh Allah, now without any delay, even a second, I repent to you. يا الله اللهم إني تبت إليك اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي وإن لم تغفر لي وترحمني لأكونن من الخاسرين. Forgive me, يا الله, in all the sin I did it, small or major, the one I know and the one I didn't do not know. Forgive it to me, يا الله, and have mercy on me, يا الله. I regret and I have the attention and I have the will that I will not return back to all the sin, the one I used to fall in. May Allah forgive all of us. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Point number 5. The people of Jannah, they understood, if they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they should repent. Why? Because the death, they doesn't know when will come. If I knew I will die after 10 years, okay, I will delay my tawbah until the last year. But since I am not, I don't know. I might die now, after 1 hour, after 1 year, after 10 years, after 60 years. I don't know. How many young, strong, mashallah. Last story I would like to mention. A person from Kazakhstan, he came to this country to study. He studied his bachelor degree, he studied his master degree. and he graduate. 7 years, his family waiting for him. My friend, he called me, he said, he's in the hospital, please come with me to visit him. I said, I am busy. No, no, please, Muad, Ustad Muad, come with us. Then I went with them all the way to hospital in Putrajaya, very far. We came and visit him. He was very sick. Subhanallah, I start giving him nasiha about the salat, because I hear that he never did salat before. He's a Muslim, but he didn't do salat. He said, how come? Teach me. Okay. I said, yalla, go have wudu. We brought the water to him in the bed. He did the wudu and we told him, please start your salah and seek forgiveness from Allah, and Allah will have the power to cure you. He said, I'm scared. I felt the devil did something to me, or black eye or something. I don't know what he's thinking. I said, don't worry about it. Just return back to Allah and seek and use the Quran as a medicine. Subhanallah, I left. In the morning I hear the news, he left this dunya. Allahu Akbar. And when his brother next day, he came to all the way to this country to bring him back to his own family, not alive, dead. Allahu Akbar. The dunya, he doesn't know when the death. He studied, he spent all the money, even he didn't get a job. He just finished. Subhanallah, the death faster than all his dreaming. All his, subhanallah, what he's have a hope for. So the people of Jannah, they understand the death can come any minute, any time. So they prepare themselves to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh people, please understand, never ever look at the sin, how small is it? But look at, you disobey whom? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at Adam alayhi salam, with one mistake, it was a reason for him to be out of Jannah. We look at the Iblis, in one sin, he achieved the angerness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he kicked out from the mercy of Allah forever. So never ever look at the sin, how small is it? At the same time, when you want to return back and repent to Allah, understanding that Allah is so much merciful. And I would like to mention to you the last story about the person, the one he killed 99 person, and he asked, the person he has so much worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doing so much worship, he didn't fall in the sin. So somebody told him about a person, he's mashallah very, you know, very good in ibadah, very good in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he went all the way to him and he asked him, I killed 99. Oh, go away from me, you killed 99, you don't have a mercy, Allah will not, you don't have any chance to repent to Allah. Then he killed him. Subhanallah. He complete with the 100. La ilaha illallah. Why he killed him? Because he make him lost hope. And that person, he is out of knowledge. He give wrong information. Then he asked, who is the most knowledgeable person? They guide him to one knowledgeable man. And he told him, وَمَنْ يَحُلْ بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ التَّوْبَةِ, who can stop you to repent and return back to Allah? Leave this city, the one you commit all that evil and evil sin and all the major sin, leave that city and go to another city and do the worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the people of that city. So the person, he straight away moved to the other city. While he's in the middle of the way, the angel of death came and took his soul. He died. Allahu Akbar. Here the angels of mercy, Ar-Rahmah, and the angels of Al-Adab, the punishment, they came and they have argument. Who should take his soul? The people of Malaikat al-Rahmah, they said, he coming to Allah in Tawbah, in the state of repentance. The Malaikat al-Adab said, no, we should take his soul because he did not do a single hasanah. Allah Akbar. He did not do any good deeds. He's not yet did any salat or any prayer or any ibadah. Subhanallah, the argument goes, then there's two narration. One narration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a judge for the malaika. He said, you major or you size the distance. Who is more closer to the city, the evil city or the good city? Then the malaika did the measure the distance. They found, there's two narration, that when he's dying, he was trying to be closer. So they found him in one spine, closer to the good city. So the angel of Rahmah, the mercy, took his soul. Another narration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered to the good city to come closer to him, and the bad city to be far away, little bit far. Then they found, subhanallah, he is more closer to the good city, that Allah has will to that person to move a land for the sake of one person to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a mercy of Allah, so huge. We never ever can imagine the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the last story I would like to mention. From there, remember, brothers and sisters, that the tawbah and repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is really, really important. And repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the character and the attribute of the people of Jannah. So every day try to have a time and moment, spend some time to say, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. اللهم إني ظلمت نفسي وإن لم تغفر لي وترحمني لأكونن من الخاسرين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لأكونن من الخاسرين ربنا إننا آمنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار ربنا إننا آمنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار. All this dua mentioned the Quran, also the dua of Adam عليه السلام. Dua of Adam alayhi salam. If we learn that dua, you will be inshallah on safe side. When he fell in the mistake, what he did? He said, Qala Rabbana. They said both, Adam and Eve, Adam and Hawa, Rabbana zalamna too. Anfusana, we wrong ourselves. Wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Always mention this dua and always say, Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. And always repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at least once a day, you know, before you sleep. Try to remember your mistakes, your shortcoming, and say, Ya Allah, forgive me and have mercy on me. And Ya Allah, accept my tawbah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your sin and wipe all your sin, how beautiful that. You walk over this earth and Allahu Akbar, your left shoulder is very light, nothing. No sin written. رَجَعَكَ يَوْمِ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ. He will return back as his mother give him newly birth. That's the one he doing Hajj. He's doing Hajj. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, whomever perform Hajj, وَلَمْ يَرْفُثْ وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ. He did not speak or utter evil words during the Hajj. He will return back as newly his mother give him a birth. That is empty and out of the sin. And for us, since we didn't go to Hajj, tomorrow is Yawm Arafah, and fasting Yawm Arafah will forgive the sin 2 years, one advance and one previous. So it's a sunnah to fast the day of Arafah, and the sunnah to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more forgiving, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah forgive all of us. May Allah have mercy on us. Allahumma inna zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lakunanna minal khasirin. Rabbana innana amanna faghfir lana dhunubana wa qina adhaban nar. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam taslima kathira. Any question? As السلامة.
What about the sin that we commit with the other Christians? Can Allah forgive us?
Yeah, as I said, the one, anything between you and the creation, you have to give them right back. And Allah will forgive if you return their rights.
If I say something back,
backbiting, back to them, yeah. Go to them and ask, please forgive me, brother, please forgive me.
So as long as I've been asked forgiveness from him, Allah will not forgive me.
If you seek the forgiveness from Allah and also apologize from him, you will achieve the both. If there's a right such as money, such as something, you have to return back. That's how it is.
When is the right, the best time to du'a during Arafah?
Before Maghrib.
Before Maghrib.
This is the best moment. Before Maghrib time. Okay, the du'a. Also good after Dhuhr. After Dhuhr to Asr time, also good to seek du'a. Also before Maghrib, we call the time or the moment of Nafra, where the people all prepared to move from Arafah to Muzdalifah, to next station. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, give so much forgiveness, and the devil and shaitan, he will be very small, and he will cry out of the view when he see all the servants returning back to Allah, and Allah forgive them. I've been, you know, trying all hard to misguide those people all these years, and suddenly Allah forgive them. So subhanAllah, he will be very minor, very small, the devil. So Arafah, it's all the day is barakah and blessing and mercy and dua and reading Quran, fasting, all type of ibadah is good, because Arafah is the best day in all the year. You know, Laylatul Qadr, Arafah like that, so much reward. So it's good to start your day until the, you know, sunset in ibadah, state of dua, state of seeking forgiveness. This is a great chance to achieve the forgiveness.